We're here with Kevin Hollinshed, Board of Trustees member from the North area. Kevin, one of the big topics discussed tonight was the North Charleston Center for Advanced Studies, North Charleston CAS. There was a proposal on the table tonight to combine Garrett and North Charleston into North Charleston High School and create a standalone North Charleston CAS building slash program. That vote did not pass. Instead, there's a delay. Can you explain why the delay, why most of the board felt it was a project that needed to be put on hold at this time?
Well, our community leaders in North Charleston, elected officials and community leaders combined, overwhelmed me with phone calls. They felt like a decision was going to be made tonight, and they wanted to be able to give their input into it because it's a big decision. It affects the way that we live in North Charleston. It affects our children, and that our elected leaders in North Charleston, along with community leaders, want to have a final input into it to better understand it, that's all.
So, after that vote failed, you brought forth a motion to form an advisory committee where the three board members for the Board of Trustees for Charleston County School District, yourself, Cindy Bond Coates, and Reverend Chris Collins, will work with elected officials from the North Charleston area, form this advisory committee to look at this North Charleston CAS proposal. What North Charleston area elected officials are you talking about besides the three of you, and what do you plan on discussing, and what is your timeline to return back to the school board in the district with what you discuss?
Well, basically, leaders like Teddy Pryor, Mayor Summey, our council leaders in North Charleston that are affected in the Garrett area, between Garrett and North Charleston, Marlon Kempson, several elected leaders, community leaders like Ed McLean, Marvin Pendarvis, Jesse Williams, guys you know like that come together and to basically kind of feel each other out, kind of see the impact that it will make to the community, listen to them, understand them, and then put it in a kind of in a form statement and bring it back to the full board. To discuss and then bring about a final resolution. We're hoping to talk about it October 9th in the Committee of the Whole, and then also vote on our main meeting coming up in that month.
Final question for you, Kevin. Tonight you were presented with some good news that there's an extra $2.3 million that have come online due to increased revenue, but it's not just going to be spent haphazardly. Can you kind of describe what was presented to you with this $2.3 million that goes into essentially a new revised budget for 2017-18 and how it will be used?
Well, first of all, it does go back into the budget. It's great that we do have that money, that surplus money to put back into the budget, but now it will be discussed by the board members and voted on by the board members where it needs to be allocated at. Hopefully if everybody agrees, it will go to teachers and it'll go back into the classroom. But again, that's a decision that has to be made by the nine.
Well, I just want to reiterate that for everybody who's watching this video to understand that the board has the final say on where this $2.3 million will go, correct?
Yes, you're right. The board has the final say on that $2.3 million.
All right. Thank you very much for your time, Kevin.
Thank you.